Hey everyone, welcome back to another Absolute Beginner's Guide, and today we're doing Mass Effect Andromeda. I'm just going to be basically showing you your main screen, which is this one, and then your menu system. It is a little bit daunting, so I'm going to show you all, well, what I've figured out about it. So let's go with it. So first off, this is the main screen. This is the one where your gameplay is at. I am on Haval at the moment doing a mission there, but I'm gonna show you the prettiness of the area while I'm showing you the information. So, first off, this is you, and there is one of my companions. There's another one of my companions, and right in front of me is a loadout station. Now, on any planet that you get, you'll get quite a few of these. They are very, very handy because you can jump between the two of them, meaning that you can anywhere where you are. If you have a mission that is close to one of these, you just go into your menu system, click that you want to fast travel to it, and it puts you there. Then you don't have to walk or run or drive with that weird rover thingy all the way there. So yeah, as I said, this is very important. I'll show you all about that stuff that we're going to do in there now. But right above that, if you look at the screen, there is a green thing. I don't know what to explain that as. Looks kind of like a space shuttle with an arrow pointing downwards. That is the sign for your rover. So you'll see that on any map that you go to, you'll see those. If it's white, it means that you haven't activated yet. If it's green, it means that it's activated. Right next to that, you'll see there is a white hexagon with a dot right in the middle. That means that that is a mission. You haven't activated that mission, so you can go onto your map, just click on that spot, and it'll activate the mission automatically. And yeah, that's your guide to where to go. Right next to that is the orange circle with another white circle in between. That's just a marker that I put on the map to give me a little bit of a direction somewhere where I want to head. You can do this anywhere. You just click on your map and it'll pop up. Now that bar on top is your direction bar. As you can see, north is behind me, there's east. See, there is another white loadout station, which means that I haven't activated that one yet, so I have to at some point in time go there in that direction and get it. And there's south. And yeah, okay, if you're on this screen, yeah, this is your gameplay screen. If you are in a battle, okay, I play as a technician, so that's why I have the weird orby thingy on the side. Not everyone will play as that, so you might not get that, but you will get the bottom stuff. You will have, basically, it shows on the left, it shows which gun I have activated now. If I flip, see, changes guns. It shows how much ammo I have in the green and how much I have in the barrel at the moment. And it also says I need to reload, so there you go. See, now I have two. The purple crescent, basically going from the left hand side to the right hand side at the bottom, is my shield. If it's depleted, that will be gone. Right below that, the red is of course my health. Right below that, I have two pictures that are, those are my current companions that I chose on this mission. It would be PB. If you haven't met her yet, she's quite an interesting character. And oh yeah, she's running away. What's your name again? Sorry, I'll figure that out in a sec. To the right of that, I have my three powers equipped. Basically, I have my turret that is incinerate, and the other one is shockwave. You can do quite a few things there. I will show you that when we do the main menu part. But this basically is just your guide to show you what you can do and what you can't do basically in this fight. Yeah, I think that's about it for this. So let's go into the menu system. Just gonna holster my weapon. Okay, you can press any of the various shortcut keys. I'm just lazy, so I'm pressing I and it pops up. This is the one of the menu systems. This takes me directly to my inventory. Now if you look at the top left, I am a level 24. My next level I will get in when I get 587 XP. Next to that is the item limit. This is the items that you can carry. I'm carrying 58 of 65, so at some point in time I need to go sell stuff, or I need to break stuff up into parts to make a little space. Okay, then this is your main menu system. I'll show you what these buttons all mean in a second. On the right, that's the amount of credits that I have by mainly selling stuff. I've picked up a few slots of credits, but they're not that common, so this is just mainly selling stuff. Next, this is my Nexus level. This is as you go from planet to planet and you do basically missions that are to the greater good, I guess, for the Andromeda initiative. You gain points for that, and yeah, I'll be on a level 7 in 60 points. That AVP is Andromeda viability points. Correct me if I'm wrong. Okay, then first off, let's start with the inventory. Let's start with the main menu, sorry. The first one on the left is your map. This is where you currently are. You see the viability here. I just recently got onto this area and I haven't done a lot of the Andromeda missions. So my viability is only at 12% now. Once you reach, I think, 70%, you can colonize the area. Oh, I have to go check up that fact. I'm sorry. Please don't quote me on that. But you'll see, once you reach a certain percentage, the mission will pop up showing you that you can now colonize. You can put a colony down there. Okay, this is the map. It shows Haval, planet surface, the chasm of the boulders. That's just the area that I am, which is this area here. I am, you see that? There you go, zoom in a little bit. The orange circle with a solid green dot, solid white dot, sorry. That's where I am. And that's the waypoint that I told you about earlier, that I just did, my direction point basically. That is a forward station, and that's one that I haven't uncovered yet. That is my Tempest. That's your ship, your big ship. This is, that's what I want to show you. If you press X, it gives you all of the information of what each picture is. So this is a monolith, and it's a green monolith, meaning that I have been there and I have uncovered all of its secrets basically. Sometimes it is just weapons or something there that you have to scan and such, and it'll turn it green, meaning that you did everything that you could there. Okay, so I'm going to take that away. These are all part of one of the missions that I need to do, and if I click on any one of them, it's a spread out mission. So if I click on any one of them, you see it activates the ones part of that mission. So if I go back into that main screen, you remember that bar running across the top? It'll now have them all there. A tip that I want to give you though, if you have one of these where there's more than one thing that you need to do, or more than one area that you need to go to, sadly, okay, if we press escape, go back, see there top, now I have a ton of them there, and it's really hard to focus and get your direction straight. So what I like to do, press M for map, is I like to use my waypoint. I put it right next to that one so that I can now ignore all of the other ones and I can just follow my waypoint, and that's right next to my mission objective area, and yeah, I'll be able to find the place. It'll be a lot easier than running around and then accidentally getting lost. But that's just my tip. You can use whatever you want. Okay, so back to this. I showed you the X again. This shows you, see, new mission. Tracked objective, waypoint, point, there, sorry, waypoint, and all of those. Okay, so at the bottom, it also gives you, you can toggle your waypoint. You can show the legend is that X that I just told you, or escape, of course, is to exit this. That is your map. Next one is your journal. This is a very important one. I've had quite a few questions on this one, so I want to show you this first off. This is all your missions that you need to do. It'll be categorized in different things. First is your priority ops. This is for the good of, or this is for the main storyline basically. Then you have your allies and relationships. As you go on, you will meet new people, you'll form friendships and allies. Your crew on the ship, they will, not each, but some of them will have a certain task that they need you to perform. This will be this. You'll get your Helios assignments, and this will be broken up into areas. The Nexus ship will have all of the assignments that you got on the Nexus. The Haval ones will be all of the assignments that you need to do there. Eos, Aya, you get the idea. As it goes on, there will be quite a few of them added as well. As you can see, I have quite a few active. I at some point have to actually sit down and get them done. Then you have your additional tasks. This is like sub quests basically. Some of them may or may not move over from a additional task onto a full-blown mission, but some of them are just smaller ones that you usually need to do for either a specific person or a specific group of people. You also can gain AVP points for this, so it might be a good idea to look at them as well. Okay, and then you have your completed missions. These are the ones that I've done. That exclamation mark next to it means that there is one that I haven't read yet. So on Aya, I got trading favors, but I haven't read what it is about yet. Okay, then you obviously saw that as well now. That is my mission. Remember on the map, I clicked on one of those white marks on the map, and it activated this mission. That's basically what this is, the same thing. It just activated. I changed it when I went into there, but it's supposed to be this one. No, it's not supposed to be that one. It is. Oh well, I'll show you in a second which one it is. I have to go find it. It's, please don't, in my opinion, please don't let your missions get as many as mine. It's so hard to track then. But what I want to show you with this is you can change your mission at any point in time, unless of course it is time related, and so far I haven't found any of those. So I can now jump from doing that one, just click on it to activate it so that that sign shows up, to doing that one. You can do that at any point. From Helios, I can go there and I can go there. Or whatever. This is how you track your assignments that you need to do, or your missions, and make them active. Or, as I showed you the other way, if you're on the map, you can make them active directly from there. It's kind of like a shortcut. So it's your choice what you want to do. Okay, so that is your missions. Next up, your journal. Next up, you will find your codex. This is every time you meet someone or you find out new information, it pops up here. Again, with the exclamation marks means that I, oops, haven't read it yet. So you can just go read it. The Andromeda species. These are some of the ones that I have found out so far. There's hostile rogues and all of those. The remnant, all of the information you'll be able to find here. Just some of them just basically has a little bit of history. Some of them has more information for you on, well, probably how to defeat them as well. Okay, that, ooh, sorry, hold on, let me go do that again. That is your codex. As you can see on the top, it has another exclamation mark, meaning that somewhere I haven't read something. I'll go find it in a little bit and just read it so that it's there. Next up, you have your inventory. And as you can see on the top tabs, your inventory is broken up into different categories. First, you have your weapons, then your armor, consumables, research, and resources. So, in your weapons, it's also broken up into different categories. You have your pistols. Now, I recently picked up this pistol, which would be the N7 Eagle 4. It's an ultra rare pistol. It does a damage of 72. Rate of fire, that's basically the speed, how quickly it fires, is 450. The max clip size is 22. The max ammo is 244. So max clip size means that you can shoot 22 times before you have to reload. But you can only carry 244 bullets. So you sh well, that's not too bad actually. But some of the guns only has like 22 bullets that you can carry. So it's one of those guns that you should not use if you are planning on fighting quite a few targets and such, because you will need to run around trying to find re-ammo cases and such. But anyhow, that's just my opinion. It's your opinion, your game. Okay, this one's accuracy is 81%, so it's fairly accurate, and the weight is 13. Now, your weight influences your speed and movement and dodging and all of that, so try and keep that under control. The gun that I currently have is one that I created, which I will show you a little bit later. Look at that damage, but look at my ammo. That is it. I sacrificed the ammo for that damage, because it's basically at this point in time mainly one, possibly two shots to kill something. So, in my opinion, it wasn't too bad. Okay, and you have your assault rifles. Same thing. You can look at whichever one. This is as you pick up or as you craft it. It'll be in here. Or if you buy it, it'll be in here. Shotguns. I don't like shotguns. They are usually terribly inaccurate, so I don't like them. But it's my game, so you can choose if you like them or not. Sniper rifles, I of course love, and I have my favorite Widow. Yes, she passed over from the previous Mass Effect, so yay! Melee is the same thing. I have an Omni Blade, and I have the Cryo Gauntlet. It's again, it's a weapon that you can equip. Then you have pistol mods. I'll show you here. These I will show you in a second exactly what to do with them, but it shows you which one you have. Again, assault rifle mods, shotgun, and sniper rifle mods. But we'll get back to these in a minute. So that's your weapons. Your armor, it's the same thing as the weapons. It does helmet, arms, chest, legs, and fusion mods. This I will show you in a minute as well what to do with that. Okay, here the chest. It shows you what it is, and on the right-hand side, it tells you a little bit about it, and it tells you there if you gain anything by wearing that armor. Same thing with the helmets. There's my Pathfinder Scout helmet that I crafted. Show you how to craft in a minute this as well. And this was given straight up with the Pathfinder, but remember I told you right now I will tell you in a little bit. I apologize. I will tell you about your mods and stuff. Now, if I go back to that, oops, that one. That, those two are from mods. Those two are from mods. Sorry. Okay, next up is the consumables. These are things that you can, well, obviously consume to enhance your gameplay, have a little bit of extra ammo, do a backup life support, all of that. You can equip them and decide there. I currently have the backup life support, and the overdrive pack. This immediately reloads all weapons. Yes. Recharges all powers and temporarily boosts accuracy and damage reduction. That was very important for me because I'm facing quite a few unhappy enemies. Here's my research. I have armor blueprints. I have uncovered 50 of them. Weapons blueprints. I've uncovered 73. Nomad 12 and special items 0. Okay, I'm working on that special items one. Basically, if you just click on it, there you go. This gives you all the information. When we craft something, that will be good to know. And then your resources, anything that you craft, you need stuff to craft it with. So this is your resources list. These are the things that you've gained so far. So you've got minerals, tech materials, biomaterials, salvage, and augmentations and special items. If I just go into the minerals, see aluminium, beryllium, there, beryllium. Ah, yeah, you get the idea. It shows you what it is and how many you currently have. Okay, tech materials, the same thing. It shows you what it is. There's a kit alloy. That's the analysis of it, the acquisition of it. And I have 684 of this. Yeah, that is your inventory. Next up, you will get your skills. And now you will get this for every single person in your party. If you level up on a planet and you only have your two squad members, when you next get back on your Tempest, go look at the other guys as well, because as you level up, everyone levels up. You can set these to auto level up. As you can see here at the bottom, you can set it to auto level up yourself, or you can in each person set it up as well. I like to control that, so I level up myself. Now, that's me. Those are the three things that you can level up for yourself. Your squad, you'd have to click on each. I'll show you that in a second. Those are the points that I have available. It says I'm a recon specialist level 24. There's my health, there's my shield, and there's my current loadout. I'll show you that as well in a minute. And I'm a technical operator. Okay, so first off, you can choose from those 5 points. I can spend in any of these three areas. Combat, I can upgrade any of these. Say, for instance, I want to go do turbocharge. Okay, turbocharge, there it says what it does. So if I want to use it, just click on it and it's done. It's used. If I don't want to do that, I can just undo changes. But if I'm happy, I can just go back and confirm an exit if I don't want to spend it anywhere else in here. And it'll ask you, do you want to confirm? You confirm, and it's done. Biotics, same thing. If you can use any of those there, you'll see every time here this the loadout that I currently have equipped pops up here. I'll show you that in a second. Now, when you've used all four or all of your points, I remember I used 1 point, so there's four left. I wanted to do that one. Plus 10 recharge speed. Yes. Okay, again back. Confirm an exit. Ha! I unlocked a new profile, pioneering scientist. Show you that what that means in a second as well. Sorry, I'm showing you a lot of things in a second, but we're working our way. Don't want to jump around and show you stuff. I kind of want to do it from in a kind of controlled manner. Bear with me. So, I have 2 points left. I am going to go into tech. You don't have to do the way I do it. It's your game, so you decide what you want. But I want the flamethrower, and to upgrade it costs 2 points, and I get plus 10 recharge speed. So I'm just going to click on it. Back. Confirm an exit. Okay. That's it. Now, to get to these, you select up, you go whichever one you want. Say assault turret. You go select power, Oops. Assign power. I apologize. You go to the one you want and you say assign power and you assign it to any of those three things. This is like the shortcut. Remember when I showed you the main menu, your gameplay menu basically. On the bottom right, there were those three pictures there that had the turret and the incinerator and the shockwave. That's it. Those are my three powers that I have equipped. You can change this into anything that you want, anything that you like, and you can also do four favorites. I'll show you that. In a sec. Okay, so that's the rider, my skills and such. Oh, by the way, I'm playing as a female. You can play as a female or as a male, it's your choice. And you can also change her look the way that you want. I wanted her to look a little bit badass and future human, so I went with that. Okay, so favorites that I wanted to show you about. Remember those? Okay, now favorites, what you can do. There's your favorites. You just click on it. Click on it, and then you can clear the selected. Okay. It goes back if you just click on it again. But you can basically, in that one, shows you the ones that I have there. I think oh no, I made mine exactly the same now in every single one. Okay. Let's go that. No. No, I don't want. Yeah, the Omni. I think I like that one. Okay, anyhow, I wanted to show you the different ones in there, but it's not going to work as planned because, as you can see from all of these, oh, that is a lot of powers that you can assign to this. So there are quite a few combinations that you can do, and that's just gonna suck. Trying to show you all of them. It'll keep you here and keep you busy for quite a while. But anyhow, that is your favorites bar. You can equip your favorites and load them from there. Decide which one you want to use and load it up. In a fight, you can change between different ones as well. It has the four, and I just screwed up my loadout completely, so I have to go work on that again and fix it. But it has the four favorites, and then if you're in a fight, you can just pause basically and equip your next favorite, or you can do your shortcut keys that I want to show you quickly. Before we come back here, let me show you quickly. And if you go into game, you go into settings, of course, you go into control and key bindings. There is all the keys that you will need. On foot, in the Nomad, and on the Galaxy map, there's all the information there. But there's your powers. Those three that we just worked with, which was mine, was the one was the turret, the incinerate, and the shockwave. I just press numlock 1, 2, and 3, or num 1, 2, and 3. But what I'm looking for to show you is probably there you are, favorite. So if I want to load my favorite number one basically, which has my three powers, I press F1. If I want to do F2, or if I press F2, I will load favorites number two, which has then different powers. So you can run through that while you're playing, which basically gives you, instead of only having three powers active at a time, you have four times three powers active at a time. That can help quite a bit. As you go through these, you can see there's a revive pack that you can use on any of your party members if you have it. Any of your party members to basically, if they're dead, you can revive them. Ammo packs, first aids, all of that. You can just go through this and try and remember your key bindings as needed. Okay, so that explains your favorites and your for rider, the skill points. Now in Vetra here, I'm going to click on, that's Vetra. She or most of your party members will not have such an advanced skill system as you do, but you do have some of the things that you have to think of. Like I have her now, you get to that point where you can decide that one or that one. And from here on, I can jump and I can do that one if I wanted. 120 damage resistance, or oh wow, melee bonus damage, weapon damage, gun accuracy, or gun stability. Let me think. I think I'm gonna go on that one. Okay, so I used her 5 points now. You can use it on any of these. Confirm and I exit. PB. I'm gonna click there. She has 5 points as well. This tells me what she has already. I am going to upgrade her shockwave next. Let's see, a plus 50% damage radius. Or plus 20% damage and 25% force. Well, it is a shockwave, so I think the force would be quite awesome. But radius makes it. You can see from the picture that's what it does. No, I'm gonna go with that one. Okay. Now, she has 1 point, but I can't use that 1 point anywhere, because as you see, my next one that I'll need to use costs 5 points. Next one open costs 4 points, so don't worry about that. As you level up again, it'll just accumulate with the previous ones. Okay, confirm and exit. And just a reminder, when you next go back on your Tempest, go in there and go update the rest of your party members, or you can. Oh, yes, I forgot about that. There's the bio. It tells you all about Vetra. Here you go. Is that? If you decide to auto level up Rider, then your party members would be automatically leveled up again as well. So it's your choice how you want to play. If you just want to play it easy for the beginning and auto level up, I haven't tested that, but I remember from the previous games you can change between the two. So if you want to get yourself familiar with everything else first, and don't want to bother with that, but want your character to grow, do the auto level up and they will basically pick it for you, and you can just assign your favorites and go on from there. And once you feel that you're okay, then you can switch that off. Haven't, as I said, I haven't tested it out yet, so it might be a good idea to test it out. Okay, that is your personal terminal. Next up, your skills. I'm sorry, your profiles. Now, as you unlock different skills and different amounts of skills, you unlock different profiles. You can switch through between these at any point in time. Between a soldier, it gives you those bonuses. Your engineer gives you those. So basically, just read through these and decide which one you think will fit you better. I decided that for this area, I'm going to do the Vanguard. So you just click on it so that there's a tick next to it, and it'll change my profile to that. Or you can press space, either or. And then That is just your tutorials. This is your gameplay menu, load menu, settings, and all of that. So, this is. That was. Sorry. That was your main menu screen and system and such. So, if there's any questions that you guys have on this or something that I didn't explain thoroughly, please just let me know and I will fix that. I already know how to use this, so I might miss something and I apologize for that, but I will fix it if you need me to. Okay. So, what I wanted to show you next is the loadout system. Remember, I said earlier that this is a very important and cool thingy to have. This is why. So, loadout. Every time that you leave the Tempest, you have to load out, which means that you have to equip weapons and armor, and you have to equip your squad mates. Now, if you go to one of these, you can change weapons and armor and squad mates. As you can see, that's your menu system. This is what I currently have, and I just unlocked another weapon. Yay! So I can now carry three weapons around instead of two. You start with two weapons. I have my melee, which is my cryo gauntlet. I have that badass pistol, and I have my widow. I'm not entirely sure yet what I'm going to put in there, but I'll go play around and I'll go look at that. And then I'll unlock that when I reach combat fitness 5. Cool. Here at the top is my weight. I'm at t minus 28% power recharge speed. See? So my weight is a little bit on the high side. I should probably look at that. See if I can, if I have mods that reduce weight. Or maybe just get a little bit of a lighter weapon instead of the heavy ones. Okay, if you want to change something, you just click on it and it'll take you to your weapons inventory. You can go assault rifles, pistols, and sniper rifles. Let me do that one. I don't want to change mine here. Click on it. I think I'm gonna go to assault rifle. And let's look. Let's compare these two. So first off, this one has more damage. This one also has a higher speed. It also has a bigger clip size, as you can see. It also has more max ammo, so I'm kind of sold already. This one, however, does have fantastic accuracy, but that max ammo clip size and damage kind of did it for me. Now, I already have two mods active on this one, so they're just going to change it quickly. If you click on, okay, sorry, did that too quickly. If you just click on, let's do this one. See, it's empty. Now, this one is, there is something already, so that's why it's showing, but it's usually empty if you get a new weapon. Click on it. You can go to any of these. It'll show you your mods list that I showed you earlier in your inventory. Here they are. And that is the information for each. So you can just go click on it, and it'll activate, and it'll be there. And yeah, Bob's your uncle. If you want to activate that into that area, click on it again, and there you go. See, now I have my three weapons and my melee, and I'm already on max 50% recharge speed. Ouch! Definitely gonna have to do something about that. Okay, so that's your weapons. Next is your armor. You can decide what you want here. That is the armor that I have. I haven't equipped or I haven't made my Pathfinder body armor for a reason. I'm going to show you how to do that now. That's the consumables that I have decided on these two to use during combat and such. And here it says cryopod perk. Sorry, you can unlock it by that. So basically, just kind of read as well. It'll give you hints and tips on what they mean and how you can unlock it fairly often. Okay, that's my squad members. If I want to change PB and Vetra, I just click on squad. Thank you. And then I can go through the ones that I have. I don't want to, I want PB here on this one, so I'm not going to change that. and Vetra, you click on squad mate 2, select, and then I can click any one of them. It's your choice who you want to use or how you want to do your team, but just a tip from me would be to try and have a balanced team. If you need someone, if you decide not to work on any of your biotics, having someone with biotics on the team can be very helpful. So then maybe look at using one of your squad mates that has fairly high biotics. Or if you want to focus on your biotics and you don't care so much for your weapons, have someone that's a good shot, whatever. But try and keep your team balanced to the point where the things that you cannot do, they can, or things that you can do, they can't, or they can do as well, and it'll build up and make it double impressive. Whatever. It's your game, but that's my tip. Anyhow, so there I can change my squad mates. And there's my car, my Nomad. I customized mine by giving it the platinum. Okay, if you take it off, that is the normal one. That is, kind of looks bronzy type. You can do that. You can give it that paint job. I like my platinum. Or you can do the common white one. So I'm going to go back with that one. If you want to change it, you just assign paint job. Here you go. And you confirm your loadout. There you go. That was your loadout. Now on each side of your loadout station, there's different things to do. Here you can extract to the Tempest. So if you think you're done with this area or this map, or you need to go somewhere else to finish this, or whatever your choice may be, you just do that and the Tempest will try and extract you if it is possible to reach in that area. Okay, it's your terminal. This is messages and such will come up here. And can I? Ooh, I'm gonna fall off. Okay, as you can see, those are the things listed from there. Now, I haven't checked yet, so let's hope I can do that. Haha! I can. I'm extracting to the Tempest now so that I can show you the rest of the stuff listed on that. I hope I haven't melted your brain yet with all the information. But when I'm done, I'll go do a quick walkthrough again. Okay. So let me just get from there to. Okay, this is the other important thing to have.
What do you miss?
Here's your research center. I want to show you how this works quickly. You have two parts of this. You have your research and you have your development. Now, research is you give them a project and they figure out all the ins and outs of it. And the development is they make it for you. That's where you craft it. So far, I have Milky Way research data that you can do. I have Helios research data. And I have Remnant research data. As you can see, every one of them has their own amount of points there. What I've noticed is as you go to a new area and stuff, and you scan things in, there are quite a few of them that actually give you research data points. So might be a good idea to constantly scan. And whenever you go to a new area, scan and see if you can click on anything. If it's orange with a yellowish line around it, that means that you haven't scanned it in yet. So just scan on it and yeah, gain your points so that you can research more weapons and armor and augmentations and such. But let me just show you one. I'm gonna go the Helios one. Weapons, these are the different ones that I can research, information that I already have and just needs to be researched, and you can go on from there.
Um,
Can click on that one. Okay, let me show you. That's the Usherai sniper rifle. It's one of the things. I already have the number one that I've researched, so I can click on number two, the second level, to research. Look at that damage. Max clip sizes though is very low, and max ammo as well, but for that damage, that's not a bad thing to have. So if I wanted to research it, I just press space and confirm. Continue. And it'll cost me 140 out of my 750 points. But I don't want to do that now. I want to do something else. And I'm not going to waste your time here to go through that. But as you can see, the same with this. You have to have the level 1 weapon before you can jump to a level 2. So if you like the Dan Shotgun 5, you require level 30, which is in 6 levels. And I'm going to need quite a few points here. So if I decide that I want this gun active at level 30, I'm going to have to start working on this and research that one, go through all of them so that I can get to that one. And then go on. You don't have to craft every single one of them, but you have to research them to get to the next one. Okay, that is just your research part. I hope I made everything clear there for you. You can do the same with your armor, your arms, your legs, your helmet, and your chest. It's broken up into that. And yeah, these are the remnant tech ones that I have. And if you go into that one, you see I have Ungaran and I have Ket and Helios Defender. These are the ones, or the types of people that I've met basically so far. Okay. Then that's your research, that's your development, that's where you craft the things. This is where it can get very tricky, so I'm gonna try and explain this as simple as possible. If I confuse myself, yeah, I apologize beforehand. Now, I ignore this screen because this is just way too many things to go through. At the top, it doesn't. This is basically all, and that's your category. So if I decide I want to go create a weapon, I'm going to click on the weapon, and I'll go from there. Assault rifle, pistols, snipers, blah 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 blah. You get the idea. But now I want to go create that chest piece, and I'm going to go into armor, and I'm going to go into chest, and I'm going to go find my pathfinder. Okay, so there's the pathfinder. It gives me all the information on it. It gives me all the what you will gain for that, and it gives me the requirements. And herein lies the problem. I do not have enough iron. So I have a lot of credits at the moment, so I basically need, let's make it 170. So I'm just gonna pop over to the next station here. My, oops, no, wrong one.
Picking back with an
The buy and sell kiosk. And I'll explain this to you in a minute as well. But I'm just gonna jump here quickly and I'm gonna go find iron. Here you go. And I'm gonna buy 100. Okay. Explain that to you in a second. Hold on. Let's go do this one thing at a time first. Okay, so development. I am gonna go there. Pathfinder. See? Now I can do. I have all the requirements for it and I can create that. What you do is you click on it and then you can click on your augmentations. It's optional, so you don't have to, but if you want to, that's it. And then these are the augmentations that I have, via either picked up or I've researched for weapons. So you can just go through all of them and decide if you want to add it. This is the Battlefield Assist module, When health and shields are full, plus 20% damage. When health is 20% or lower, plus 25% resistance to all damage. Oh yeah, that is a good one to have. So then the next one. Okay, well, I only have four, so I'm gonna put those four up anyhow. Here you go. When you're done, you click craft. And it'll ask you if you want to change the name. You can change the name if you don't want it to get lost between your other things and you just want to go, this is my awesome set that I use for, I don't know, going out with the girls. You can change it there. Otherwise, just press enter. And it says Pathfinder Scout Armor developed successfully and added to your inventory. Yay! Oh, and I just got. Cool. Okay, and you can go for the Nomad as well. You can create stuff for the Nomad as well. And most of them would be automatically equipped on the Nomad. I did see one that you had to equip, but I sold that one because it wasn't really worth it for me. But you can craft any of these. And again, you can craft any of the guns, you can craft the weapons, the armor, sorry, the Nomad, if you have the stuff for it. And there's your special items. I don't have any blueprints for this, so I'm kind of excited to see what that would be. I wonder. Okay, that is your research and development in a nutshell, and your crafting in a nutshell. So let me know if you didn't
Why?
understand that or
Want to
if I
change your
missed
answer?
something, and I will
Maybe.
help you figure that out. Okay. Next on this thing, you have your strike team missions. This is where you can decide if you want to. These are all missions that need to be done. You can decide if you want to join a team and play multiplayer from here, or if you want to send a strike team. Now, I sent a strike team and I have to debrief them. Let's see, did my mission fail? Oh, damn it! My mission failed. Let's go try another one. Send a strike team. It says I have a 78% chance of success, and the time required is it's almost 4 hours. So we'll come back in 4 hours and see if it failed again. Okay, that's your strike teams and stuff. You can go through each one and decide how you want to use them or if you want to join them. It's the multiplayer basically. This is my AVP status control. Remember those points there? Now you get points from this as well. As you go on, you get cryopod points, these ones here, and you can use them to unlock people that will do certain things. Wake people up basically from their cryopods, and they will like the commerce pods. There I put one with trade capacity. There will be a lot of people, or not a lot of people, but people involved in that specific area will be woken up and they will start doing their job and they will start gaining the Andromeda Initiative, that valuable asset, and you as well. See? Here I earn credits from investments at regular intervals. My military pods, special forces receive tech materials at regular intervals. And there at the top, you'll see I have three rewards to collect. So I can just collect all my rewards. And then it says I acquired 100 Milky Way research data. Yay! I acquired minerals. Yay! And I acquired tech materials. So I can go craft more stuff or research more stuff. It's your choice what you want to do. If you want to do science, military, or commerce, yeah, it's your point. Okay. And that's the blind cell kiosk is the other one that I want to show you. On the right-hand side is the buy, on the left-hand side is the sell. So if you want to look at something, just click on it. And you can compare it to what you currently have. I can compare it to the Widow, which is my sniper rifle. So you can see that changing by that. If I compare it to my Widow, it's red, so it's less damage than the Widow. Green or yellow. I can't really see if that's green or yellow. We'll say it's greenish. That is more. Well, you can judge that by the plus, anyhow. Okay, so if you want to buy something, you just click on it. And you confirm trade. You can reset the trade as well if you accidentally confirm the wrong one. Or you can sell all for salvage. I haven't done that yet. I'm kind of terrified that I'm going to sell everything in there. So I'll let you guys know at some point in time if I actually do that and what happens. Okay, no I don't. Or you can, oh it's probably going to, oh okay, you can click on, sorry, the wrong button. You can click on my items and you can sell from your side. It shows all of your items in your inventory at once, so this is one thing that I do not like, and I really wish that they would do something about that. But yeah, for now it's that. There's your weapons, you can do it like that. Your armor as well, it does it the same way the other does. You can sell and stuff. Your consumables, your resources, and for the nomad. But there was one thing why I didn't like this one as much. It was, okay, if you go through this one, it shows you your mods and chests and augmentations and stuff. But what I wanted to show you is this. The material. It says there, to salvage it. Oh, that's what the all salvage would mean. Well, that's right. Ha! It selects all your salvage things. Remember, if you look at the salvage, it says, sell at a merchant for credits, value moderate or high and stuff. If you click that, it automatically selects it. Okay, so I just learned something else. Fantastic. So I'm going to sell that now and then we can go on from there. So what I'm going to do is confirm trade and I'm going to say okay. And they're done. They're out of my hoard. Sorry. So now I have a little bit more space, and I need to go through my weapons and my mods and stuff and go sort that out. So now I can go to weapons. Again, that's just the way I do it. But yes, my pistols, I only have the one pistol that is in my inventory. It's not being equipped, so I can sell it if I want to. Okay, there you go. If you press page down there, you can compare it with what you have. Now my Usher is my current pistol that I have equipped. So I can compare it with that and I can decide if I want to keep it or not. Now, as I said, I sacrificed my clip size for fantastic damage. So hence why there is a massive difference between these two. But I'm guessing probably at later stages as well, you will still find a few of the weaker guns. You don't have to pick them up if you want to, unless you want to sell them. But yeah, I picked these up. So I'm comparing this and I still like my gun that I have. So I am just going to select the item and I'm going to confirm the trade. And there you go. I can go back and I can go to assault rifles. And there's the matlock. Again, this is the ones that you don't have equipped, so you won't accidentally sell the gun off of your back or the clothes off of your back. Okay, you can do the same thing with your armor. I have the Angaran helmet. I had actually quite a few complete armor sets, but I had to make space. So, yeah, I sold them. But anyhow, you can do that with your with any of these. Go on and sell and buy. If you don't want to sell, you want to buy. Again, there's your shortcuts menu. There's your weapons, and you can buy from there. Same principle. Click on it. Confirm trade. Voila. Okay. That is that. One other thing that I want to show you, and this is the last thing. I'm going to stop the video here
Strike team ready
because
for deployment.
I'm probably, yeah, probably melted your brain. If you go into your inventory, not at any of those centers, but in your inventory normal, you can go to a weapon or whatever and you can deconstruct it. If I deconstruct that gun, that is what I will gain. Okay, that's the gun that I have active with the tick. Armor. I can deconstruct it. And I will gain all of those. So you can use that then to craft as well. If you're out in the field and you need to craft a better gun or better whatever, or you've reached your item limit or whatever, you can go through and you can deconstruct the things that you want to get rid of. You cannot, however, I haven't seen any of the mods that you can deconstruct. You can only destroy them. Let's see if. Let's do that one. No. Okay, we'll do that one. We'll destroy it. Yeah, see? It just destroys it and gets rid of it out of your hoard. Okay, so that's that. I think that I've run through most of the things at this point in time. So if there's anything that I didn't explain again, please just let me know and I'll figure it out for you. Okay, I'll show you. You see right above my head, there is the star that is where I need to go. It pops up if you're fairly close to where you need to go, and it'll show in meters as well how far am I away from it. Okay, so hope that makes sense, and hope this helps you play your game, enjoy and play your game a little bit better. And yeah, have fun. Thank you for watching.